Ken Workington with the call of the two-year-old Colton Gelding Pace of the Breeders' Crown.
Colt Pace, purse of $300,000. Gate picks up speed in the back stretch. There they go. And they're off. And out quickly is Riyadh, part of the one entry, the Bill Robinson stable entry with Brett Robinson. And from the outside, that's Bonnie and Clyde and Campbell doing battle with Riyadh early. Bonnie and Clyde trying to clear. Riyadh on the inside, second. Alante Spur is third. Presidential Ball got away good, and he's going up on the outside for Jack Musayev as they head for the opening quarter mile. Life Sign gets underway. Then it's Columbus Avenue, Village Jiffy, and the early trailer is Tibet. The opening quarter, a quick 27 seconds flat. Campbell clears with Bonnie and Clyde. Here's Presidential Ball. Campbell and Musayev are stride for stride by the grandstand, and Campbell's parking out Musayev. As they hit the club turn, it's Bonnie and Clyde, and Presidential Ball can't clear. And he'll tuck in second behind Bonnie and Clyde. Life Sign now goes after Bonnie and Clyde. There goes Life Sign with Bill Fay. Out of fourth, Riyadh on the move past the half. On the outside, Village Jiffy is fifth. Alante Spur is sixth. Then it's Tibet and Columbus Avenue. Life Sign takes a shot at Bonnie and Clyde. Roughs them up. They hit the half in a brisk 54 and 3/5. A lively clip here. Can Bonnie and Clyde stand it? Life Sign's right there on the outside. Presidential Ball now hemmed in. Riyadh on the outside, inches up now, closer third. As they head to the far turn, looking for an opportunist, we've got Village Jiffy sitting chilly in the fifth spot, looking three wide for Waples and looking for an upset. Tibet follows him, 1:23 and 3 3/4. Life Sign on the outside by half a length. Bonnie and Clyde trying to battle back. Here comes Village Jiffy on the outside, Tibet on the far outside, extreme outside Columbus Avenue. They're in the stretch, it's Life Sign, but here's Village Jiffy, and the Breeders' Crown long shot man, Ron Wimples, does it again. Village Jiffy, Life Sign, Tibet closing on the outside, far outside Columbus Avenue, but it's Village Jiffy in the upset, 1:53 and 2.
So Ronnie Wimples does it again, Village Jiffy the winner. And coming from off the pace to do it, the two-year-old bay colt by Campfella out of the direct scooter mare Village Jig, owned by Charles Armstrong, Wellwood Stables, and minority partners Alan Burks, AFJ Stable, and Fred Bruner.
Well, if there's one man that can take advantage of the misfortunes of others, at least the horses, it is Ron Wimples. His ninth Breeders' Crown win, and this is the fourth that has gone off at more than 25-1, or just about 25-1, I think that's what this colt is. Unbelievable, takes advantage of that 54-3, which is a sizzling half, and here comes Village Jiffy on the outside for Ron Wimples. Nobody does it better than Ron Wimples, and he comes on a win. Nobody expected this colt to win, believe me.
Well, we'll see if no one expect him to win, because the pick six obviously depends on whoever was smart enough to pick this one. These smart boys with the early strategy burned one another out, as it turns out. Neither one of the two horses that everyone thought would win were able to handle this one. And again, as you mentioned, Ron Wimples, king of the upsets, scores another.
So Wimples, who won the Crown Age Horse Trot last week up in Canada, does it this time on this side of the border. Village Jiffy, your winner. Well, Ron Wimples does it again, this time with Village Jiffy. Village Jiffy in the money this year, 10 of 13, won a division of the Prix de Levenaire at Bluebonnets, and trainer Bill Wellwood is also a part owner.
This horse has won $134,000, so you might consider him an overlay in this race, paying the price that he did. But in any event, Wellwood, who was unable to win the three-year-old trot with two trotters, scores here as a partner with Village Jiffy.
And you know, Stan, a two-year-old, it's so difficult to keep a two-year-old sound and racing at the top of his game for an entire season. Hence, Presidential Ball was beaten.
Strategy was the result.
All right, Gary Seibel standing by in the winner's circle. Let's check in with Gary.
We are here in the winner's circle. I know there are a lot of jubilant people out here as well, because you were 25-1 and their horse won. Your ninth Breeders' Crown win, fourth 25-1 or more. Pretty amazing.
Maybe I should look for the 25-1 shots instead of the favorites, I guess.
Okay, we're going to take a look at the replay now, Ronnie. And you were just biding your time, pretty much.
Well, everything went real well. The pace was real strong in the front end, and he was nice and relaxed, this colt, and I'd never had to ask him at all anywhere except around the last turn where I went three wide with him right here. And he responded real good, and he went handy, really, but it was because of such fast early fractions that done me the good.
When you went three wide, did you think at this point that you really had a good shot of winning?
Yeah, I felt very good. I looked over in Presidential Ball, looked like he was tiring a little going up the backstretch, so I felt real good right there.
Lifesign put in a good effort, but you went right by that colt as well.
Yeah, he had a tough trip. He had to come end up first over up the back. Just it was a tough trip, and his misfortune was my good fortune.
You know, tonight's five Breeders' Crown winner is pretty short prices, but you closed out the night with a real banger there.
Well, long shot players will be happy.
Okay, and your thoughts on winning your ninth Breeders' Crown?
Well, when's the 10th?
Well, it could be a couple of weeks from now in Cleveland, eh?
Sounds good to me.